He said I would buy a congressman and make basically the problems would go away at that point in time. And that is directed. That will stand in my mind for the rest of time.
Over the past 2 weeks, the U.S. Coast Guard has held hearings into the tragic implosion of the Titan submersible of June last year. These hearings have uncovered alarming new revelations about OceanGate, with a clearer picture emerging of CEO Stockton Rush's arrogance and delusion. The reasons employees gave for leaving the company gives insight into just how dysfunctional the environment at OceanGate was. I have extracted parts of their testimony describing a workplace where safety concerns were trivialized and compliant employees normalized dodgy practices.
And why did you depart the company?
Got fired because I wouldn't let him go to the Titanic. Allegedly, what Stockton tells me, he invited me to lunch and told me that Mike Ferlotti and one other board member told him that I should have known that the hull was compromised and it wouldn't work. And either he or I had to go, and Stockton said it's not gonna be me.
OceanGate was clearly in severe financial distress. Before the final season, the sub was left to overwinter in a parking lot at the harbor.
My final question is, why did you depart OceanGate?
That the decision had been made to tow the sub behind the polar prints. When we were on the ship in 2021 and 2022, there was constant work, almost 24/7, except when they were diving on the sub. You know, we worked very hard on trying to keep things as best we could. And so this would have required us to work on the platform, and the platform bobs up and down, and I just did not see that I could do that, or I did not feel right that other people who were working for me would be required to do that. I expressed that, and the reasons were, you know, economic reasons, and I suggested that they not go, you know, that it was just not a workable solution. It was just too dangerous. In addition, the company asking us to forgo getting paid for periods of time, clear that the company was economically very stressed, and as a result, that they were making decisions and doing things that resulted in, I felt that the safety was just being compromised way too much. You know, they had people that paid and that they had to go through with it. So that was the reason that I left, basically. Yeah.
Can you kind of explain to us why you decided to leave OceanGate?
After that meeting, it became abundantly clear to me that OceanGate was not the place I wanted to work. If that was their attitude towards safety, then I didn't want to work for that company. I had full trust in David Lockridge, and if he wasn't there, then I could not be a pilot there. And after that meeting, I went home and updated my resume and started looking for another job.
During Titan's 10th dive to the Titanic, a loud bang was heard upon resurfacing. Here, an engineer on board describes her experience. Two different strain gauges attached to the hull registered permanent deformation, almost certainly indicating delamination of the carbon fiber pressure vessel.
We were going through the debrief, and one of the customers stated that on ascent, as they were getting fairly close to the surface, but they heard a bang as loud as an explosion. I later spoke to some of the people who had been in the small boats helping with the launch and recovery, and one of them told me they heard it from the surface. Stockton's response when the customer brought that up was to kind of, it seemed to me, immediately shut it down. I recall him saying, "We're not at the part of the debrief where we're discussing ascent and recovery, so we'll discuss it later." Later, we got back to it, and he, again, just sort of, I felt brushed it aside. He said, "Well, it was probably just the sled banging against the frame." I just felt that didn't seem like the customer's concerns were taken particularly seriously in that meeting. So I went to Amber Bay, the director of administration, to raise my concerns about what I had just heard. I'm really concerned about what this customer has said, and that there was a bang as loud as an explosion. And I asked what's being done. And her response to that was that, yes, many people are concerned about you. You don't seem to have an explorer mindset. And I was kind of taken aback by that because she didn't acknowledge what I had just said. And I continued pressing on it a little bit to kind of say that, you know, reiterate that I felt this was quite concerning, especially in the context of the haphazardness I'd seen in the rest of the operation. And everything I said, she sort of turned it back around on me and said, well, you know, yeah, you have a bad attitude. You know, we're innovative and we're cowboys, and a lot of people can't handle that. By the end of that conversation, she asked if I wanted to be sent home, and I said yes. And so, you know, they booked me a flight for the next day.
This is a plot of the strange gauge data. The thin blue line is the dive depth over time. The permanent jump in strange gauge coincides with a moment of the loud bang. Despite this alarming data, dives continued without proper investigation, even when subsequent dive data indicated sponginess in the carbon fiber structure. I will expand in the next video. Titan would implode four dives later. The problems seemed unending. On the seventh dive to the Titanic, the front dome fell off onto the deck because it was secured with too few bolts. On that same dive, the batteries died just before recovery. This was a company basically going rogue with people's lives.
And I was asking about, you know, how are we doing this with the plan to take money for going to the Titanic? And ended up with Scott taking me to lunch with Stockton. I brought up the concerns that I had regarding operating without a COI and not being inspected. He had a long list of issues and reasons why regarding, you know, the complication, stifling the ingenuity and all these things. He tried to explain the mission specialist aspect to it, said that they were going to flag the Titan in the Bahamas and launch out of Canada so that they wouldn't fall under U.S. jurisdiction. I think I'd expressed to him that still taking U.S. passengers on there for hire at any point in time, if they touched the U.S. land port, that would also be of consideration. Basically ended when he, if the Coast Guard became a problem, that he would buy himself a congressman and make it go away.
Mr. McCoy, is that a direct quote?
He said, I would buy a congressman and make basically the problems would go away at that point in time. And that is direct. That will stand in my mind for the rest of time. I've never had anybody say that to me directly, and I was aghast. And basically after that, I resigned from the company and I couldn't work there anymore.
The hearings also told of enormous amounts of cash sunk into a jerry-built contraption that few customers were brave enough to sign up for. The business case was a dead end with only a few dive opportunities in the tiny weather window each year. There was no way they would ever recoup their investment. Stockton Rush was caught in a trap of his own making. While trying to maintain the illusion that all was good with the vessel, that by all accounts was on borrowed time. It is amazing they could find any customers brave enough to sign up because despite the huge ticket price, the lack of any certification, and the loophole of having to call paying passengers mission specialists made it clear these dives came with little to no promise of safety. Eloquently described by this client from Dive 7.
Would you have felt safe going down to depth again after that loud bang?
Well, that's an interesting question. Anyone that felt safe going to depths in the Titan was deluded or delusional. I mean, it was an experimental vessel. It was clear that it was dangerous. And anyone that wanted to go was either... And it was either delusional if they thought it wasn't dangerous, or they were just embracing the sense of risk. I mean, it's kind of like jumping out of an airplane. I mean, you don't do it because it's safe. You do it because it's an adrenaline rush. And yeah, I would have gone back down again. I mean, that we weren't going down in search of safety. We were going down in search of adventure and exploration. Mm-hmm.